Welcome everyone to another Monday night Orange Practica at the Beat. Cristina and I are happy to be here for an extended period of time. And we had a theme for what, for the whole month?
Crosses,
yeah, theme for crosses. And this is probably our last Monday doing crosses, although Thursday we will probably continue one more time with crosses. What's important when you're crossing behind? What's
tight.
That? Yeah, instead of fanning out like this. Okay. Good. How do you make forward progress when you cross behind? Yeah. Lift the heel by bending the knee.
Okay, and then what are some extra tips for us followers who are wearing high heels when we are doing this crossing behind exercise?
Articulate quickly.
Yeah. Metatarsals. Yeah, articulate our metatarsals so we can unwind safely and avoid scraping the top of our standing foot with our high heel.
By the way, after doing hundreds of these videos, we had a comment that sometimes people can't hear your answer when they're watching. I mean, technically it is for you who have been in the class, but we will sometimes try to repeat the answer, so don't feel like we're belittling you. We're just maybe making it more accessible to people who are watching. There was also an exercise we gave if we're going to do like the enrosque exercise. If I start with my left, and then halfway through I do what?
Pivot.
Yeah, pivoting cross.
Shift weight.
And then if I start with my left, how do I step back?
The same one.
Yeah, also with the left. Okay, and I can go with the right, hook behind, 180, finish pivoting and step back. This exercise can be done with a partner. I recommend followers try it. Followers can do all sorts of enrosque type things without a weight change, but for right now, you can try adding the weight change. And what's the trick here? What do you have to do with the hips?
Open.
Say it again.
Open?
Yeah, open the hip to step close to our partner. So you stay together. Good. What was the first exercise that we did when we put it all together after the ochos?
The snake.
The snake walk. Yes. What are some secrets to the snake walk?
Pinching your knees together.
Yeah, I have to pee. You can exactly. You can pivot a little bit if you want, and then what stays on the floor right now?
Toe.
Yeah, try to keep your big toe. Later you can kind of make a step, but it's safer with the toe on the floor.
And followers, what kind of back steps are we trying to make here?
Perfect
back steps. Perfect back steps mean what?
Straight.
What else?
Connected to him.
Connected to our leader by reaching too long?
No.
Just reaching enough?
Just enough.
And then, besides reaching enough, what is the other important thing? The what? After we reach, what happens?
The weight shift.
The weight shift. The timing of that weight shift. We want to try to do it really carefully.
So besides doing the snake walk, what else can I do in that cross way of walking?
Skateboard.
Rollerblading.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. If I rollerblade, what does my partner do?
Back ocho.
Yes, the no pivot back ocho. If I don't turn what?
Your shoulder.
My spine, yes. I'm around a corner, there is pivot, take the curve. And you can flow from one to the other. How did we ask you to get into this and to get out of it when we ramped up? Yeah, with a cross. So, in open embrace, what side's easier? Left, good. And then also you can get back out. And finally, for the followers' chance to do a cross in this class, what did we do? kind of cross for the follower?
Back cross.
Back cross. Where did we lead it from?
The snake bomb.
Or the walking back ochos.
The walking back ochos is easier, okay? And then if we do the walking back ochos, how do we stop? We start our rollerblading and then what? Do we collect all the way with the other foot?
No, half collect.
Half collect.
Keep this open stance and shift weight from right to left.
Yes, correct. And just keep it more compact and tight. You can suspend your partner a little bit so they have more information.
Okay, followers, this shift of weight, what does this communicate to us? The hook behind. And then what else?
Change of weight.
The hook behind and the change of weight. Yeah?
If you're less experienced, how many can you do?
Six.
And as you get more experience, you can go beyond that. And then one way to come out is just to go back into your ochos or your snake walk. We had a whole pattern planned that combined last week.
That's okay.
So you want to do it. Okay.
But maybe just do a half turn to the right, finish with an ocho cordale.
So
we wanted to propose that maybe after leading your follower with a couple of hook behinds, you can lead them a half right hand turn, and you can finish in an ocho or ocho cortado if you want to remain in close embrace. You'll probably have to lead three. One. Three. And then here's a turn to the right. Here's a four.
Do a little demo.